Despite some resolution of late 19th century labor conflicts, relations between the brewery workers and management remained tense into the 20th century. And by the middle decades, relations between management and labor were strained. Local 9 of the Brewery Workers Union went on strike May 14, 1953, affecting the Schlitz, Pabst, Miller, Blatt's, Gettleman, and independent breweries. They demanded a 35-hour work week, a raise in pay, and free health insurance. Management would not concede, resulting in a 76-day strike at the height of the brewing season. Eventually, the management of all the breweries in Milwaukee gave in to the union's demands. This was seen as a victory for Local 9. However, beer production dropped dramatically that year, hurting the overall economy of the city. In 1981, members of Local 9 went on strike against Schlitz after they failed to renew their contract. On September 30th, 1981, Schlitz sent its employees a notification of termination and closed its doors. This action had ramifications for Miller, who the courts determined to be in violation of the collective bargaining agreement with Local 9 when it hired non-union temporary workers rather than laid off former Schlitz employees. After years in court, Miller finally settled with 39 former Schlitz employees in 1987.